Can you guys see the triangle?
Yes.
Okay, I did it just now. Okay, look, do you see the fold of the angle A here? I just have to make it touch the tip. Did you see that?
Yes.
Now I fold this angle C here and I get it at the center. Okay, look here. And I get the angle B here and I make it touch the other two angles. Okay, did you see that?
Yes.
Okay, now do you see that all these three angles make up a straight line when I put them together?
Yes.
Look. 1 minute. Watch, guys. Is it clear? Everyone?
Yes.
Okay, cool. Chalo, let's move ahead now. Where is my pen? Okay, so I hope there are many ways. Now, another way, guys, the same thing, you cut this top part, you cut this part, and you cut this part and keep it next to each other, it becomes a straight line, okay? Chalo, now let's move on. So, I hope that's pretty clear that so we saw three methods. One is you take a protractor, you measure it. Do I have a protractor with me right now? Guys, do you see this? Guys, can you see this? Yeah?
Yes.
Okay, so you take a protractor, you measure it, and you can see it's 180. Second, you cut the angles, place it next to each other, it becomes 180. The third is, you fold the top angle to the bottom and make it touch the segment BC. Then you fold and get angle B to that point where A touches the segment BC, and the same you do with angle C, it becomes a straight, it forms a little rectangle or square depending on your triangle, and second, it forms a straight line. Let me show that to you. 1 minute. I'm moving this. Guys, look, do you see that? Whatever I do, yes. Can anyone tell me what's happening to the triangle? What do you think it's happening to the triangle? Yeah, anyone?
The triangle is moving.
Yeah, it's moving, it's dancing, okay? So, the dancing triangle shows that in any situation, the angle will always remain. In any situation, the sum of the three angles always remains?
Same.
No, what same but?
180.
Correct. Now, let me show you. Now, I'm shutting this, okay? Chalo. Let me shut this. I have one more thing to show you. Okay, 1 minute. Yeah. So all the things I've got so that I can show it to you. I'll also share the links of all this with you so that you guys can do it yourself. You don't need me to do all this and explore, okay? 1 minute. Where is Ira, Jay, Rutuja, Swatika, Vedan? Where is Bhavish gone? Where is... Who else was there? Ashay to chalo got bumped off. Bhavish is missing. And who else is missing? Chalo, theek hai, I don't know. Too much network issues with you guys. Chalo, you guys see a new demonstration, guys? Is that pretty clear? You guys see a new one? Okay. Rutuja, Ashay, Jay, Swatika, Vedant, Bhavish, you guys see a new demonstration? Come on. Yes or no? I've asked the poll. You guys see a new demonstration? Yes or no? Okay. Cool. Chalo, let me show you. Now, guys, look here. Do you see that I have the measure of these angles here? 1 minute. Oops, sorry. Yeah. You see, I'm moving these angles. I move the triangle in any form. See, guys, can anyone quickly read? 1 minute. 1 minute. Play. Yeah. Guys, I hope you guys can see in any way this triangle moves, the angle always remains 180. Okay? If you see this approximately here, guys, if I pause this, you see that if the angle is, 1 minute, if this is the angle, you see M angle CAB here is 113 degrees. M ABC is 49 degrees, 113 plus around 50 degrees means is 163. And BCA, this little acute angle here is 16 or 17 degrees. 163 and 17 makes it 180. Okay, so in any situation, CAB, ABC and BCA remains 180. I hope that's very clear. This is very important. It is used in all your future classes for all quadrilateral, polygons, triangles, circle, anything that you will do up to 10th standard, your 180 degree C. Guys,